Ladies and gentlemen, good evening.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, sir.
Can you join the... How do I see your faces here? Yes. Gian. Grian. It's my first time to use this big blue button and
nakikita po kayo.
Ha? Saan makikita? Camacho. Okay. Kindly allow yourself to be viewed on camera. It's for your attendance, ha, ladies and gentlemen. So you have to. I see Mr. Camacho. Okay. Grian. Puntero. Dumasi. Come on, make it quick. Why are you only 2, 4, 6, 8, 10? What happened to the others? Okay, anyways, we'll catch up. Last meeting, I had given you an assignment, right? Aside from the identification quiz. And also, last meeting, we have reviewed the SPAT report and the first progress report in relation to the scenario I had already given you. Am I right, ladies and gentlemen? Come on. Is it your first time to use this app?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Sige lang. Pag-aralan natin. It's quite similar with the Zoom. Noon pala. Now, part of your assignment number 2, aside from the progress report, is the affidavit of witness Watchman Joy Inana. Diba? So, we only checked the SPAT report in the first progress report. However, we weren't able to check the affidavit of witness Joy Inana. The memo request from COP addressed to Police Colonel Walang Ligtas, the Chief Regional Forensics Unit, for the conduct of fingerprint identification, di ba? Wala pa yon. Also, the transmittal or chain of evidence of the latent print, the developed fingerprint, from the crime scene on and those of the suspect. And last requirement for your assignment number 2 is the memo result of the fingerprint identification from Colonel Walang Ligtas, Chief Regional Forensics Unit, addressed to Police Major Jack Matarusan, COP, Chief of Police of La Trinidad Municipal Police Station. Do you recall? Can you still recall that assignment? Before we go further with the second progress report, may I ask from the class, who among you were able to comply these four, aside from the first progress report, ha? The first progress report was already checked last meeting, di ba? Yung pinakit, yung sinend ko sa inyo. Also, the spot report. Have you watched the video? Hala. Ang exam nyo, report writing, kaya dapat alam nyo. Now, before we resume, do you have a problem? Meron ba kayong hindi naiintindihan on your activities? Any statement? Statement na lang kung ano yung mga na-encounter yung problema. Just be honest. Sir, we weren't taught how to do this, to do that. So, kindly raise it now. Or forever, hold your peace. Yes, ang Alan. My former student in PE4 yata, di ba?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Oh, go ahead.
Sir, yung kan, yung sa kan sana, sir. Yung, ano na yun, yung ilalagay na, yung sa pinakataas ng affidavit of witness, sir. Sir, kung ilalagay yung Republic of the Philippines or yung kan lang, sir. Yung may naka-indicate pa bang regional trial court, ganun, sir?
Ah, wag na.
Yung ganun ba na affidavit of witness?
No, no, no. In the affidavit of witnesses, affidavit of arrest, do the format as you were taught in your technical writing one. Kung ano yung format ng technical report writing one nyo, yung affidavit of loss, gayahin yung ganun lang. Anyways, ang importante naman doon is the, kunwari, lawyer na nag-subscribe ng affidavit nyo, di ba? Because it will be signed by two persons, you and the lawyer who subscribed your affidavit.
Sir, any lawyer ba or yung prosecutor na mag-handle ng case?
Pagka kayo yung complainant, syempre prosecutor, pero pagka sa defendant, pwedeng yung PAW, pwedeng yung defense counsel niya, di ba? So prosecutor sa atin kasi tayo yung police kayo, di ba? Kayo yung investigator. So, it should be subscribed by the public prosecutor. Sige, sige lang. Sige pa, ano pang tanong? Because I wanna see how creative you are. Actually, the important facts were already forwarded to you, di ba? All you have to do is to apply what you have learned in your technical report writing and what you have learned in this course. Well, we weren't able to discuss spot report and progress report, but it was discussed on the video I forwarded you during our first week. I required you to watch that and take a note of the important facts therein, discussions therein. Pareho lang din yun eh. Kung pag-aaralan natin yun, ulitin ko lang din yun. Yun lang din. Yun lang din ang discussion natin. Now, any violent reaction from the class?
Well, none, sir.
Are you sure? Because if we have no problem with construction of affidavit and memorandum yung spot report nyo, progress report, and final report, ah, also the request for conduct of fingerprint identification, memorandum type yun. Sorry. And also the reply of the chief forensics to the COP, memo type lang din yon. Kaya wala namang iba doon, hindi naman kayo mahihirapan. Ang gagawin nyo lang is gagawahan nyo lang ng content, pero i-form nyo lang into memo type or affidavit type, di ba? That's all you have to do. Now,
sir, yung akin po.
Ha? Yes, Charming.
Sir, yung sa akin po, nalito lang po ako sa mga, ano, yung mga date. Like, kunwari, sir, di ba, yung, yung spot report, kunwari ngayon po, ngayon binigay.
Spot report po.
Tapos, okay. Bukas na ba lahat, sir, yung mga, ano, yung like, affidavit, yung mga ganun ngay, sir. Medyo okay. Nalito lang po.
Yung, okay lang. Kung wala namang nakalagay dun sa fax na date, pwede nyong gawin. Bahala na kayo. Pero if I already mentioned the date in the fax, then follow the date. Yung spot report, dapat sundan nyo kung kailan natin ginawa yung spot report. Yun ang pinaka-importante. Dapat i-date nyo rin doon yung spot report because spot report must be submitted not later than 24 hours. But for significant incident, it must be submitted and it must reach the office of the chief PNP within 1 hour. Ganun kabilis dapat pag significant incident yon. Pero kung ordinary incident, okay lang within 24 hours. But for the progress report, okay lang na medyo madali yon. Kahit basta hindi pwedeng nauna yung date ng progress report nyo or date ng incident ng progress report doon sa date sa spot report, ha? Maliban na lang kung ang sinasabi ng witness is before the date of the incident, we met. Mga ganun, okay lang na mauna yun, di ba? Pagka parang history. Yes, Mr. Did I satisfy you, Charmaine?
Yes, sir.
How about you, Mr. Taranco? Also my former student. You raised your hand a while back. What's your question? Anong tanong? Or problema?
Sorry, sir. Sir, regarding po dun sa chain of evidence form, ano yun, sir? Mag-research po talaga kami ng form or memo type lang din po?
Hala. Di ba last meeting, I said, you need not research on the form, on the actual form, because we have no clearance to use that. Anyways, if you are already in the service, then can you make use of the proper form? So temporarily, let's all make use in let's make use the memo type. Memo type lang lahat. Parang spot report or progress report or final report lang. Ang ibahin nyo lang naman is yung subject niya. So ano yung subject niya? Request conduct of fingerprint identification. Tapos yung isa naman, memo type rin. Ang subject niya, result of fingerprint identification. Di ba? Ganun lang. Tapos yung activity 3 nyo, ay yung quiz number 4 nyo, memo type rin yun. Anong ni-require ko sa inyo? Affidavit. Application for search warrant. Memo type. Di ba? So anong ilalagay doon? Memo type. Hindi nga lang siya ano. Letter nga lang dapat to kasi from COP to judge. Pero pwede rin, memo type, pwede rin memo type rin. Ang subject na lang niya is request issuance of search warrant. Tapos attached the affidavit of witnesses. Di ba? What is, by the way, the basis of the judge in issuing a search warrant? Now, what? That's why I required you to have a definition of terms. Di ba? Sabi ko, define a search warrant. Define a warrant of arrest. What is a warrant of arrest? Warrant of arrest is a written order issued by a judge directing a peace officer or a law enforcer to apprehend the person named in the warrant of arrest and bring him before the court in order for that person to answer for the commission of an offense. Diba? So yun ang warrant of arrest. Now, how about a search warrant? It is a written order issued by a judge addressed to a peace officer or law enforcer directing him to search for the specific item described in the warrant of arrest and bring it back to the court. Now, ano yung ngayon ang tanong? Ano ngayon ang requirement ni judge for the issuance of a search warrant? Diba? Search warrant must be issued upon the conduct of preliminary examination din, diba? So, ano yung focus ng preliminary examination? To determine probable cause. So, what probable cause? To determine probable cause that a crime had been committed and the product or items or the subjects of that crime are located and to be searched in that place stated by the witnesses. Ganun lang. Do you have a question, ladies and gentlemen? So, wala kayong problemahin. You may not follow the proper format. You may make use of the memo type. Memo type na lang. Wag ng letter. Memo type na lang lahat para hindi kayo malito. Tapos, memo type and affidavit lang. Yun lang yung pinire-require ko sa inyo. You will only differ in terms of your sentence construction kung paano yung gagawin and at the same time on how you proper attach documents. Why? Because in preparation for your ano na yung may moot court kayong subject? In preparation for your subject, law 4 A and B ang tawag namin doon noon eh. Criminal procedure. In preparation for your subject, criminal procedure, we are preparing a case folder. Case folder yung hinahanda natin dito. Oh, sinong hindi makasunod? Do you have a problem with spot report?
Spot none, report? Sir.
None. How about the progress report?
Sir.
Yes, Patricia. Kindly answer honestly so I'll know how to adjust. Patricia, you raised your hand a while back. Do you have a question? Oh, Grian, ikaw.
Sir, nan po. Napindot lang po ata.
Sige. Alberto, Janil.
Sir, wala po. Pinalitan ko lang po yung audio ko po.
Sige. Janil. Ito, you're a lady. Yes, Dumasi. Do you have a question? Angalan. Sige, angalan.
Sir, okay lang ba na kon na request acknowledge receipt pag di sure na matatapos yung progress report, sir? Yung ilalagay sa pinaka-less na sentence?
Ah. Request acknowledgement receipt? Hindi dapat ganun eh. For information lang pagka memo. Pero kung i-email nyo, kunwari ito, spot report, i-email nyo, saka nyo ilalagay siguro sa email na request acknowledgement receipt. Doon sa chat box ng mail. Pero in the memo type, you need not put it. Ang lalagay nyo dapat doon na last is yung mga requested actions nyo. Kung ano ba yung requested actions nyo? Kung for information, edi for information. Pero kung for nagre-request kayo, kunwari, yung parang request nyo for conduct of fingerprint identification for appropriate action. Yun ang ilalagay nyo sa last sentence niya, di ba? For appropriate action or for your utmost consideration. Mga ganyan. Did I satisfy you, Mr. Angalan?
Yes po, sir.
Okay. Any other questions?
Sir, edi sa ano po? yung chain of custody form at request for FBI identification, hiwalay pa rin po ba yun, sir, or iisa na?
Actually, is hiwalay dapat yun, pero pwede, I'll consider yun kung ginawa yung isahan lang, but it's supposed to be separate. Ang importante lang naman doon is meron siyang parang acknowledgement receipt in one coupon ban, okay lang, in one coupon ban, that the from the investigator na receive ni evidence custodian yung fingerprint, and from the evidence custodian na receive naman ni fingerprint identification expert yung fingerprint. Parang ganun lang. The importance of your chain of custody, ladies and gentlemen, is it proves to the court during trial that the evidence was not tampered. Diba? So yun yung importance ng chain of custody form. Or transmittal. When we say transmittal, yan yung transmit nyo yung evidence from one person to another. And syempre, dapat proper person yung magre-receive. Kasi kung ibang person yan, there's a tendency na baka doktorin yung ebidensya. Pag na-doktor yung ebidensya, nalaman na sa court, pwede tayong makasuhan. Diba? Pwede tayong ma-countercharge, tampering of evidence. And at the same time, madi-dismiss yung kaso dahil we will not be able to prove the guilt of the perpetrator. Bakit? Because the evidence was tampered with. So, madi-dismiss yung kaso na final natin, at ang worst dyan, makakasuhan tayo ng criminal case. Anong criminal case ang ipapato sa investigador? And not only the investigator, but all the persons within the municipal police station, pwede yan, to include the COP based on the command responsibility principle. So, pwede yan. Madadamay lahat ng madadamay. The worst here is administrative case. Bakit? We can be dismissed because of that. And we know for a fact that tampering of evidence is a motu proprio investigation, a case being investigated motu proprio by the IAS, Internal Affairs Service. Yan. So, did you understand what I have just said? Naintindihan nyo ba?
Yes, sir.
Now, who has a question aside? Ang Alan, ikaw ulit.
Ano sir? Pa? Ay, sir, paano pala pag equal rank, sir? Yung pag may message mo, parang, sir, di ko narinig kasi nung last meeting, either chat.
Okay, listen. Pagka equal rank, we call him subordinate, sabi natin eh. Subordinate, equal rank, or lower. Pero pagka higher, superior. Pagka superior, we are sure we will be making use of the word for. Diba? For. Pero pagka equal rank mo, to be safe, pwede rin ang for. Lower rank, 2 ang gamitin mo. So parang from COP, di ba? From COP to chief of the regional forensics unit. Mas mataas si forensics unit kasi regional office siya, di ba? At saka colonel yung rangko niya. Si COP is only a major. So, ano ang gagamitin mo doon? Ang alan? 4 or 2?
Sir, 4.
4. Now, how about if the chief of the regional forensics unit had already drafted his reply. Ano ang gagamitin niya? 2 or 4? His reply to the
sir,
COP.
2.
Oh, 2. That's correct. 2. 2 dapat. Any other questions? Yes, Kati.
Sir, in memo type po ba yung ano lang, yung spot report tsaka yung progress report yung may references?
Spot report lahat yan. Memo type lahat yan. Spot report, progress report, final report, all investigation report. Meron din tayong sinasabing investigation report. So ano yung investigation report? It contains all the data from your SPAT, all the progress report and final report. So isang kinumpleto niya, yun yung investigation report. Sa whole. And also,
sir, parang dito kasi sa
Sige lang.
Dito kasi sa request for fingerprint examination, 'di ba, in memo type 'yun, sir. Kailangan ba ng reference 'yun?
Of course, kailangan ng reference. So, anong inilagay niyo yung reference doon? So, pwede niyo i-reference yung SPAT report mismo, yung previous na report, yung mga naunang reports. Aside from that, parang yung pinakita ng classmate nyo nung last, di ba? Ay, hindi pala. Yung isang section yata yun. Sinama niya rin yung blotter entry number. Okay lang din yun. Blotter entry number, SPAT report, reference, progress report. Pwede nyo isama yun.
Thank you, sir. Kama lang ginawa ko.
Oo. Sige, any other questions? Or any problems you have encountered while complying your quizzes? Quizzes turned out assignment. No. Who else encountered problem? So wala kayong napansin ko lang, wala kayong problema sa affidavit, no? Who has a problem with the affidavit? Let's say for example, under your quiz 2, affidavit of witness, Joy Inana. So it shall be signed by the witness, Joy Inana, and at the same time, subscribed by the prosecutor, ha? Tapos the content concentrates on the statement of Joy Inana stating that the suspect has, yun yung companions niya, 3, that she was then invited before by those companions of the suspect, together with the suspect. Pala, apat yata silang nag-invite. Now, yes, Taranco, rumor.
Sir, ano pwedeng pa-check na lang ng affidavit na ginawa namin, sir, for...
Okay, sige, later. I'll just explain this type of evidence to you. Have you tackled your evidence? CLJ 5 or 6 yata or 7 evidence? Not yet?
CLJ
6. Oh, CLJ 6. Have you tackled CLJ 6? Hindi pa.
Yes, sir.
O, di ba?
Kuha pa lang, sir.
O, sige. Now, in CLG 6 evidence, rules on evidence, we have how many types of evidence? We have the physical, real, or autoptic, or object evidence, di ba? We have the documentary evidence. Aside from that, we have the electronic evidence. We have the testimonial evidence. Now, if the real autoptic or object evidence cannot prove the guilt of the suspect alone, this will say kulang yung ebidensya natin, we can make use of circumstantial evidence. So now, if you have observed our scenario, hindi kasi directly na nakuha ng CCTV yung guard, di ba? Na naging suspect siya. Hindi siya nakuha na ng CCTV. So pwede ba natin kasuhan yung guard? Pwede ba? Walang direct evidence na magpapatunay na gumawa siya ng krimen. Meron ba? Wala. Meron bang ebidensya? Physical or object evidence? Pointing at him? Wala, di ba? So, ang meron lang is yung statement lang ni Joy Inanna na kasama ni Joy, nakasama ni Watchman, sino yung katrabaho niya? Who's this?
Juan Turog, sir.
Ha? Juan Turog, di ba? Nakasama ni Juan Turog yung tatlong nagnakaw. So, if you come to think of it, we are all connecting circumstantial evidences, pieces of evidence. So, lahat ng mga evidence natin, circumstantial, kumbaga. Maliban na lang sa CCTV footage itself, na nakita natin yung tatlong tao. Pero, our evidence against the guard, Juan Turog, wala. Walang direct, di ba? So, kumbaga, parang circumstantial. Yun yung ini-establish natin dito. Kaya pinagdudugtong-dugtong natin para maging isa, para masama siya sa complaint. Kung ang kakasuhan lang natin is yung 3 suspects na nakita sa CCTV, okay lang, di ba? Okay lang. Pero wala silang pagkakilalan, walang pangalan. Diyan daw pa lang. Isa naman lang, may na-identify muna tayong isa. Sino yung pwede nating ma-identify? Yung guard pa lang muna, di ba? Kasi siya lang yung may pangalan. So, in-establish natin yung circumstantial evidence against the guard and 3 jandos, his companions. Can you understand the logic here? Pwede ba nating kasuhan si... Pwede ba nating isama si Juan Turog sa complaint? As of now, in relation to all the available evidence and affidavit we have, pwede ba hindi? Who has an idea? Sige.
No, sir.
No. Bakit no? Bakit no? Bakit no? I already forwarded you the content of the SPAT report, the content of the first progress report, and the content of the first progress report and second progress report. So, let me read it again, the content of your second progress report. So, we have here the facts. A concerned citizen in the person of Mr. Akin Balay voluntarily reported to La Trinidad Municipal Police Station that he positively identified the suspects in Benguet State University robbery case captured by the CCTV, which was posted by LTMPS on Facebook. So, means to say, LTMPS posted the video footage of the 3 suspects carting away 3 big boxes from the Nursing Department of BSU. So, yun lang yung pinost nila for identification purposes. And a witness voluntarily appeared, he said, stating that he identified the suspects. Now, continuation, Mr. Balay mentioned that the said suspect currently rented Mr. Balay's boarding house at room 3, house number 33, Butag, KM6, La Trinidad, Benguet. One of the suspects was identified by Mr. Balay as Mr. Bayad Abang, the person who transacted with Mr. Balay and who paid the rent for the month. So, may na-identify itong isang witness natin. Upon watching the post of La Trinidad Municipal Police Station, Mr. Balay carefully inspected the room of the suspects. However, it was closed, locked, and left unattended. So walang tao sa loob pero naka-padlock. Pinadlock ng suspect for almost 5 days unattended, ah. 5 days unattended. A glimpse of the room, so sinilip niya. A glimpse of the room from the uncovered window shows a box. So isang box lang 'yung nakita niya. Additional progress, review of adjacent CCTV suggests that the suspect carried the boxes towards the direction of KM6 Butagla Trinidad Benguet. So from BSU, another circumstantial evidence, a CCTV footage, showed that the three suspects carried the boxes from BSU and headed towards the direction of Butag, La Trinidad Benguet. So, it jived with the statement of Mr. Balay. So, yun yung content ng second progress report nyo. Let me read again the content of your first progress report for you to recall. For us to recall. Okay. So, you are an investigator with the rank of police corporal in the La Trinidad Municipal Police Station. Your chief of police is Police Major Jack Matarusan. And the provincial director of Benguet Police Provincial Office is Police Colonel Kayan Beta. On September 21, 2023, at 6 o'clock p.m., La Trinidad Municipal Police Station received the reply memo from Chief Regional Forensics Unit stating that the latent print from the crime scene matched the fingerprint of Watchman Juan Turog. Ah, meron pala. Nakalimutan ko to. O nga pala. Nagmatch nga pala. So, meron na tayong direct evidence. However, the prosecutor may require suspect Juan Turog to submit his counter affidavit. Paano kung sabi niya sa counter affidavit niya is nahawakan ko yan after I have. Responded. So, yun lang. Review of CCTV on the same day showed three men wearing jogging attire carting away three big boxes from the place of incident. The muddy shoe print did not have any match yet. So, wala pa tayong update kung kaninong sapatos yan. Watchman Joy Inana, during a follow-up interview, stated that Watchman Juan Turog was or has three male companions whom he regularly meet outside the campus. She knows it because she was once invited by them for a dinner last month, August 2023, to which Joy Inana declined. Now, my question a while back is, can we include suspect Juan Turog in the complaint? Aside from the three suspects who carted away the three big boxes? Yes, Miss Vina.
I think yes, sir. Huh? I think yes, sir, kasi... yes po sir, kasi di ba nagmatch po yung fingerprint niya dun sa ano. So magiging kabilang siya dun sa mga suspect until mapatunayan niya na
innocent siya.
Yes sir.
Yes, okay. So that's one. I almost forgot that. So nagmatch nga pala. Aside from that, what other evidence can we make use as basis in including him as one of our accused? Aside from the positive fingerprint. Kasi the problem here, pwede siyang mag-counter affidavit later on. Sabihin niya, no, the latent print was uh, deposited after we have responded because I failed to use gloves. So pwede kasi sabihin niya 'yon sa counter affidavit niya later on. Dapat kaya dapat maghanap pa tayo ng other evidence. What any other evidence can we include?
Sir, kakilala niya yung tatlo.
Kakilala niyo yung tatlo. So the affidavit of witness of Joy Inanna, di ba? So that's one, di ba? That's a circumstantial evidence. Circumstantial evidence yung affidavit ni Joy Inanna, circumstantial evidence. So your physical evidence there is the latent print. Your circumstantial evidence is the affidavit of Joy Inanna. What else? As of now, wala pa, di ba? However, during his testimony, pwede natin tanungin. Kasi there was a conflict with his statement, di ba? Mayroon siyang conflict na nasabi during his first interview. So, yun yung magiging subject ng ating direct examination with him later on. Diba? And if he will be proven to have lied while under oath in a trial, can we file him another case?
Yes, sir. Perjury.
Oh, tama. So, perjury ang kaso. So, that's the importance of your definition of terms. Dito natin gagamitin yung mga yun, definition of terms. I-inject natin. Now, my question again is, can we now move for the filing of the case against the three suspects? Three suspects pa lang, yung three suspects who were seen carting away the three big boxes. Pwede ba? Can we file the case?
Sir, pwede yata.
Pwede na.
Yes,
because we are establishing if we can already file the case. So, if we can, we will be already preparing for the crafting of a final report, di ba? Final report na tayo next meeting. So, pwede yung tatlo. Now, how will we identify the three suspects? Sino yung isang suspect na na-identify out of the three suspects who carted away the big boxes?
Bayad Abang, sir.
Bayad Abang, that's correct. So, ang pangalan niya later on, pagka yun final natin, suspects Bayad Abang, ay accused Bayad Abang, and two John Doe's. Yan. To be later identified. If Bayad Abang will cooperate, then he can name the two other accused in relation to a plea bargaining. So, 1 degree lower, pwede rin yun. Depende kung aamin siya, kung sasabihin niyo yung dalawa. Pero kung ayaw niya, edi we can still resume with case against him alone. Siya malang muna. But the question is, can we include the security guard? As an accused in the case?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yan. Di ba? So, we have two. Okay? We have two. So, dalawa na identified accused natin. Juan Turog and Bayad Abang plus two John Doe's. Now, my question again is, what will be our evidence or pieces of evidence against these four suspects. Based on all the facts provided already, what are our available evidence against these suspects are accused?
Yung testimony ni Aking Balay, sir.
Wait. One by one, please. Nagsabay-sabay na kayo eh. Let's start with Mr. Cathy. Nauna siya eh. The testimony of... before the testimony, of course, mauna munang statement. Mauna munang affidavit yan. Affidavit muna yan bago maging testimony. Okay? So, reference of his testimony is his affidavit. Yan. So, affidavit muna tayo kasi ipafile muna natin yan. So, documentary evidence yung affidavit niya, di ba? Documentary evidence. So, the affidavit of witness. Who is that again? Mr. Miller? Affidavit of? Di ba kayo sumagot kanina?
Hindi yata ako yun.
Ah, hindi kayo yun. Sino yun? Sino yung sumagot kanina? Kaninong boses yun? Akala ko ikaw yun. Testimony of, sinabi niya kasi. Palitan lang natin. Affidavit of Mr. Akinbalay, di ba? He identified the three suspects. I mean, one of the three suspects. So, isa yun. Aside from that, what else? Sino yung nagsalita kanina? Oh, we have already identified one evidence. Documentary evidence. The affidavit of Mr. Akinbalay, who was able to identify one of the three suspects who carted away the three big boxes from BSU. Aside from that, what other evidence?
Sir, affidavit of witness by Watchman Joy Inana.
Oh, affidavit of witness Joy Inana, stating that his co-worker, Watchman Juan Turog, is company of the three suspects who carted away the three big boxes. So, we already have identified two documentary evidence. What else? Ano pang ebidensya? Come on, ladies and gentlemen. Eh, di ba? Binasa na nga natin kanina. Ano pang ebidensya?
Physical, sir. Yung physical evidence.
Oh, sige. Physical evidence. Ano physical evidence?
Yung fingerprint, sir.
The fingerprint. So, that's the third. The physical evidence is the fingerprint, which matches the Latin print lifted from the crime scene. It matches the fingerprint of the suspect, Juan Turog. So, yan. So, we have one physical evidence and two documentary evidence. What else? Ano pang ebidensya natin?
Sir, electronic.
Electronic evidence. What type of electronic evidence?
CCTV, sir.
Tama, di ba? The CCTV. Don't you ever forget the CCTV footages. So, dalawang CCTV footages na yon, di ba? Yung isa na pinost ni La Trinidad Municipal Police Station at saka yung isa showing to where the three suspects showing their direction that they headed towards the direction of Butag, KM6, La Trinidad, Benguet. So, dalawang CCTV footages. Now, my question is that enough? I mean, the CCTV, is that the CCTV footages enough? Or it has a prerequisite before it can be accepted or before it can be admissible as evidence in court? Any thought, ladies and gentlemen?
Sir, yung affidavit of investigator po.
Sige, isama natin yung affidavit, documentary evidence of the investigator. Ano yung sinabi ni investigator? That he reviewed the CCTV, di ba? So, pwede niyang pag-connectin yung dalawang CCTV footages sa review. Tapos, aside from that, his affidavit when he responded to the crime scene. Anyways, pwede niyang gawing isang affidavit lahat yun. So, yan. So, affidavit of the investigator. Okay yan, okay yan. Now, what else? What else? Going back to my question ni while back. Are the CCTV footages enough? Will it be admissible in court already? Or it has a prerequisite before it could be admitted by the court? Let me rephrase the question, ladies and gentlemen. In terms of CCTV footages, for a CCTV footage to be accepted as evidence in court, are there a prerequisite or wala?
Meron, sir.
Oh, yes. Miss Vina, ano yon? Ano yung prerequisite niya?
It shall be authenticated by the person
Yun yung hinahanap natin. It must be proven to the court that the CCTV footage was not edited. So we need a certification of authenticity or genuineness stating that the CCTV footage was not edited. So kailangan natin yun. Okay? So kung kaninong CCTV yun, kukuhan natin siya ng certification. And at the same time, he will be testifying in court in relation to the certificate he had issued. Okay? So ilan na ang evidence natin yun? First, the fingerprint of Watchman, di ba? Of Watchman Juan Turog. Second is the affidavit of Joy Inana. Third is the affidavit of Mr. Akinbalay. Fourth is the affidavit of the investigator. And fifth is the CCTV footage plus six, the certification of authenticity or genuineness from the owner of the CCTV. So we don't have yet update in terms of the shoe print. Wala pa tayong update hanggang ngayon. Now, Let's see, kunwari, judge kayo. Kunwari, judge kayo, ha. Is there a probable cause based on your assessment? Is there a probable cause that the accused is the person who had actually committed or the accused, apat pa sila, are the persons who had actually committed the crime? Probable cause. May probability ba? Na sila yung gumawa ng crime?
Yes, sir. Meron. Yes, sir. Basing from those evidences.
Oh. Okay. So, with that, ladies and gentlemen, can we now proceed to the filing of the case? With all of those evidences.
Yes, sir.
Pwede na ba tayong mag-file ng kaso? O, pwede na, di ba? Pwede na. Hindi lang yun, ha? Hindi lang yun yung tinanong natin. Pwede bang mag-file ng kaso? Pwede. Pwede ba nating kasuhan yung tatlong suspect? Pwede. Pwede ba nating isama yung guard na allegedly kasama niya? Pwede. Yan. So, depende na lang sa counter affidavit niya kung i-exclude ni guard yung mapa-exclude nung guard yung katawan niya, sarili niya. Depende rin sa content ng kanyang counter affidavit and with his attached evidence. Depende rin. Now, so yun na, at least naintindihan niyo yung flow. Break tayo dun sa requirement a while back. Hindi ko pa talaga na-check rin. Affidavit of witness, Joy Inana. Did you have a problem? Because if you had, I will give you an extension to correct that. Extract it from the Google Drive and replace it with your final affidavit. Do you think you have to correct the attachment? Are all your documents? Or we'll proceed with it? Because if we'll proceed with it, I'll just check it now already. I will record it. I will score it already. But if you think you have something to correct, then I will give you another time to correct those. Lahat na. Lahat ng mga na-enumerate ka natin. Na-enumerate kanina. Request memo for fingerprint identification. Reply memo with the result of fingerprint identification. Affidavit of witnesses. Witness inana. Affidavit of witness Akin Balay. Hindi ko pa pinagawa to sa inyo. Affidavit of... Ay, meron na pala. Affidavit of investigator. Meron na rin pala. So, do you think you have to correct it, ladies and gentlemen? Or you are good with what you have submitted?
Correct, sir.
Ah?
Ulitin, sir.
Ulitin, sir. Ulitin nyo. Para mapataas naman yung score nyo. Oh.
Kailan, sir?
Ah?
Hanggang kailan, sir?
Hanggang next Saturday. Ah, this Saturday pala. Madali lang naman yun, di ba? Kunti lang naman yung i-edit nyo. So, extract it na lang lahat. Extract nyo na lang lahat. From, sige, kahit from quiz 1 to quiz 1, quiz 2, and quiz 4. Yung quiz 3 nyo kasi, identification eh. So, extract nyo na lahat yun. Yung quiz 1 nyo, quiz 2, and quiz 4. I-correct nyo na lang lahat para minsanan.
Sir, so pwedeng hanggang next week?
Saturday, sir.
Ala, grabe naman.
Sir, yes.
Kunti lang naman yung kukorek nyo doon. Kunti lang naman. Di ba? Kunti lang yung kukorek nyo doon. Otherwise, we will be left behind. May iwan tayo ng syllabus. We will not be able to finish it on time. Ay, wait lang. Matanong ko nga. In your technical report writing one, have you studied the definition of terms and the requirement of affidavits, mga ganyan? Before you crafted an affidavit? Diniscuss nyo ba yung mga parts ng affidavit, mga ganyan?
Yes, sir.
So, mga ilang weeks kayo bago kayo gumawa ng affidavit? Mga ilang weeks from the first meeting?
Sir, matandaan ko yung after discussion may ano agad.
Ah, so mabilis. Yun nga.
Sir, yes.
Mabilisan. After the discussion, meron agad activity. So, hindi tayong pwedeng magpahuli. Did you understand the video presentation on SPAT report? On all the investigation report? The first video I sent you, naintindihan nyo ba yun? Or there's a need for me to clarify that, to go over that?
Sir, okay lang ba correction tape para di napalitan?
Correction tape? In court, ladies and gentlemen, anong isipin ng judge pagka puro correction tape naman ang evidence nyo, di ba? Parang tampered with yung evidence nyo. So, dapat ayusin nyo yung walang erasures. Case folder nga, maging case folder nyo nga yan eh. One of your final requirement. Kaya dapat maayos. And that will serve as your pattern later on if, ewan ko lang kung sino maging instructor nyo sa criminal procedure. Because he will be requiring you to simulate a case and you will be like testifying in court. Parang ganyan ang gagawin nyo. So, ang ginagawa lang natin ngayon is in preparation for your moot court. Di ba? Parang continuation niya lang yun. Kaya as much as possible, dapat perfect yung document, yung mga evidence natin. Yung reports, affidavit, and the case folder as a whole. Have you crafted already or have you drafted already an example of a counter affidavit in your technical report writing?
Yes, sir.
Hindi pa po, sir.
Bakit hindi kayo magkakapareho? Si Vina nakagawa. Who was your instructor, Miss Vina?
Si Sir Jefferson Pianitog po, sir.
Ah, bakit yung iba hindi?
Sir, mas nag-concentrate, sir, kami nag-concentrate kami sa ano, yung parang, yung change of name, change of color ng ano, tas yung mga affidavit of loss po.
Ah, other legal forms. Pero yung kasing sa inyo is hindi madalas sa bagay, kung kasama kasi sa board exam. Pero ang madalas kasi na napapansin natin, kung magiging pulis kayo later on, are those related to criminal cases? Kaya, kung related sa criminal cases, yun dapat yung inaaral natin. Counter affidavit, reply affidavit, affidavit of witnesses, yung mga yun. Turnover receipt or transmittal. Request conduct of ballistic examination. Diba? In short, request conduct of forensics examination. Lahat na yun, kasama ng ballistics, personal identification, question document, and so on and so forth. Depende sa kaso. Sige. Counter affidavit. Hindi lahat kayo nakapag counter affidavit. Sige, I'll see what I can do. Aside from counter affidavit, did your instructors before like required you to create a sample of a search warrant or and a warrant of arrest?
Wala sa amin, sir.
Ah, wala. Yun yung wala.
Sir, ma'am.
Meron?
Sir, yung application for search warrant, sir.
Application for search warrant, meron?
Wala po, sir.
Ah, wala.
Wala, sir.
Hindi, okay lang. Okay lang yung affidavit. Ah, okay lang yung application for search warrant. Kasi gagawin nyo lang naman dun eh. I-memo type nyo lang naman. I-request nyo lang. Kanino naka-address? Kayo nung honorable judge ng kung kaninong court yung may handle nung kasong yon. RTC 63 yung nilagay ko, di ba? So, ilalagay nyo lang. We respectfully request for the issuance of a search warrant to search for these items. Ano ba yung item na nandun? 3 big boxes, di ba? In the residence of this suspect. Sino ba yung mga suspect? Talagay nyo rin dun, di ba? Tapos, attached is the affidavit of witness. Sino yung witness? Sino yung mga witness na ano, na bumuo nung ebidensya? Lahat ng available witness showing or proving or showing the probable cause, ilagay natin doon sa application ng search warrant natin. Yung affidavit ng investigator, di ba? Nakita niyo yung CCTV? Nakita niya sa CCTV na may tatlong tao na nagbuhat ng 3 big boxes, tapos ang direction nila papuntang Butag. So that's the first circumstance. The second circumstance is the affidavit of witness Akinbalay. Ano naman sabi ni Akinbalay? That the three suspects, he identified the three suspects posted by the CCTV, posted by the LTMPS, to which one of the suspects there he positively identified as Mr. Nakalimutan ko ulit, di ba? Who paid his rent to who directly paid his rent to Mr. Akinbalay. So, ganun lang. Before we request, ladies and gentlemen, ha, let me remind you that before we request for the issuance of a search warrant, the witnesses will be examined by the judge. So, pag may affidavit na yung witnesses, kailangan pa bang mag-examine si ay mag mag-ulit sila? Hindi na, di ba? May affidavit na yung mga witnesses, eh. So, yun na lang i-attach natin. May affidavit na rin naman yung investigator, i-attach na lang natin. Pero kung wala pang affidavit yung mga witnesses tapos they are applying for a search warrant, then can the judge examine the witness on that day mismo? Tama nga pala, tama. Aside from the affidavit, the witnesses will also show themselves physically to the judge. Tama rin pala. Kasi tatanungin rin siya ni judge. So, tama rin. Sasama pa rin sila aside from the affidavit of witnesses. If there exists a probable cause, then the judge will approve the issuance of a search warrant. But if there's no probable cause, then he will decline the request for issuance of search warrant. Diba? So that's the difference between search warrant and warrant of arrest. In a warrant of arrest, the police officers need not request for the issuance of a warrant of arrest. Why? Because by the time that the police officer had filed the case, submitted the case folder, that case folder will be examined by the judge. He will conduct preliminary examination. And if there exists a probable cause, then the judge will issue the warrant of arrest for the arrest of the accused, diba? So that's the difference between your warrant of arrest, the issuance of warrant of arrest, versus the issuance of a search warrant. Any other questions, ladies and gentlemen? 7:30 time na. But I am willing to extend so long as you are also willing to listen. Are there matters or agenda to be discussed? Tanungin nyo, dali, isipin nyo kung mayroon kayong mga na-encounter na problema nung ginagawa nyo yung mga pinagawa ko sa inyo. Lahat yun ha, from quiz 1 to quiz 4. Kung mayroon kayong problema, naging problema, ask it now. Because if you have no questions, then I presume you have understand all our discussions, and I will be collecting your activity by Saturday, by this Saturday. Wala na?
Tanong lang po pala yung sa progress report po, dalawang beses po ba pala talaga yun?
Yung progress report, di ba sinabi ko na sa inyo, walang limit ang progress report. Every day na merong progress in relation to the case, gawahan nyo ng progress report. So, pwedeng first progress report, pwedeng second progress report, pwedeng umabot ng maski ilang progress report yan. Depende. Basta mayroong improvement, mayroong newly discovered evidence or newly discovered witnesses, isama natin as a result of the follow-up investigation. Bakit? Ano ba yung basihan ng progress report? Yung mga follow-up investigations, di ba? Ano bang basihan ng SPAT report? Yung first respond ng investigator sa crime scene. Ano naman ang basihan ng final report? Yung the presence of the docket number issued by the prosecutor. Kasi iba yung docket number ng prosecutor, iba yung docket number ng court. So, ang docket number ng prosecutor, if the investigation is a product of an inquest, INQ, di ba? INQ-2023-month siguro, tapos kung pangilan siya. But if the investigation is, if the investigation resulted from a plain investigation wherein the suspect fled from the crime scene and the police officers were not able to apprehend the perpetrator, yan, INV-2023-month-09- kung pang ilang docket number na siya. As of date. So, ganun lang. Did I satisfy you, Mr. Angalan? Si Angalan din?
Yes, yes po sir. Salamat po.
Oh, any other question? Clarification. Wala na? I presume you have understood everything we have discussed, ladies and gentlemen. So with that, bakit nawala yung mga ladies ah?
Sir.
Bakit mag-isa mo
sir,
lang
ba? Sir, pwede bang sagutan natin?
Ha? Ha? Come again?
Meron po pwede ba, sir? Sir, pwede po bang sagutan natin yung quiz para alam namin kung ano, saan kami nagkamali doon?
Ah, o nga pala. Nakalimutan ko kung saan Google Form ko ginawa yun sa dami ng Gmail account ko. Puno kasi, kaya gumagawa ako ng ibang Gmail account ko. May problema sa G Drive. What was the first question? Kindly read it. Can you retrieve the questions?
Sir, what is the longest type of investigation report?
Oh, di ba sinagot ko na kanina? Progress report. Bakit? Because it can have first, second, third, fourth progress report, and so on and so forth. Until we are able to file the case. What else? Kung 2 words sabi niya, progress report. Pero kung 3 words, progress investigation report. Kung 3 words. Pero kung 2 words ang hiningi niya, investigation report, progress report lang. Next question. Next question.
Sir, it refers to the type of event which should reach the office of the CPNP within 1 hour.
Significant incident, di ba? Significant incident. What else?
Sir, pwedeng significant cases po.
Cases? Hindi mo ba ma-recall yung incident? Kaya cases ang nilagay mo?
Ano pa crime incident, sir?
Crime incident is too broad. It's too broad. Pwede pa. Ang problema rin kasi is, ano yung
Sir, paano kapag... Sir, paano pa kapag sensational crime, sir?
Sensational... It's too specific. It's too specific. Kulang din. Because sensational cases are all only part of significant incident. And significant incident does not only involve crimes din. Kaya significant incident talaga. Yun lang yung sagot talaga dun. Ano ba example lang significant incident? Namatay si Presidente nung pumasyal sa Baguio. Was he a victim of crime? Hindi siya nabiktima ng crime. Pero Presidente siya. Politician. Maging significant incident 'yon, 'di ba? Hindi crime. Pero because of the authority of the subject, it becomes significant. Kaya hindi pwedeng significant crimes. Hindi pwedeng significant case. Significant incident lang talaga 'yung sagot doon. Ala, di ba sinend ko sa inyo yung video? Kaya dapat, di ba kayo nag-take down notes? Basahin nyo lang naman yung sinulat nyo. Yun, andun lang din naman yung mga sagot. 10 items na nga lang. What else? Question?
This is a written report concerning the actions taken of a person authorized to gather information and evidence in relation to an act. in violation of a law.
Ilang words yan? 2 words lang? Kung 2 words, investigation report.
2 words, sir.
O, investigation report. Bakit? Ano ba yung inimbestigan niya? Violation of law. Violation of law refers to criminal case. Diba? Investigation report. Kayo naman.
It is a document containing an incident in violation of a law perceived by a certain person other than the victim or the accused who is willing to testify in relation thereto, and document is duly subscribed by a lawyer.
Affidavit of witness. Ang simple-simple, di ba? Hindi suspect, hindi accused, pero willing to testify in court. Anong tawag doon? Witness. Pero document siya, affidavit of witness. Any other question?
It refers to the first written report containing all the available facts pertaining to a crime incident drafted by authorized personnel with technical writing in investigation.
Wala, halos tinanong mo na report, lang. Di ba spot report yan? First written report containing all available information regarding a case, criminal case, spot report. Pwedeng hindi criminal case yan, ha? Pwedeng ano lang, pwedeng accident lang din. Diba? So, spot report pa rin yun. Containing all available information relating to an incident. Spot report. Andun na nga yung first, yun yung clue nyo. First written report. Sino nakakuha doon?
What type of investigation? Sir, ako po.
Yung may docket, yung prosecutor docket, final report ba yun, sir?
Oo, final report yun. Pagka 2 words, final report. Pagka 3 words, final investigation report. Pero ang nilay ko doon, 2 words lang. Kaya final report lang yun. Sige, continue. Ano yung nagbabasa kanina?
It refers to a sworn written statement of a person accusing someone of a felony or offense subscribed by a private lawyer. Complaint, sir?
Complaint.
Private, di ba? Complaint. How about if the subscribing officer is the public prosecutor? Anong tawag?
Information, sir.
Information.
Di ba? So that's the difference between information and complaint. Pagka si prosecutor, information. Pagka private lawyer,
it is a
complaint. Sige.
It is a written order issued by the judge commanding a peace officer to bring in a certain person in order that he may be bound to answer for the commission of an offense.
That's basic. Warrant of arrest. Di ba? Pina definition of terms ko lahat yan sa inyo. Hindi yata ikaw yung gumawa ng assignment. Submit ka ba ng assignment mo? Or kinoconfirm mo lang yung sagot mo?
Kinoconfirm lang po kasi hindi po kami pare-pares ng mga hindi nasagutan, sir.
Ah, okay.
Kaya tinanong ko na lang po lahat.
Sige lang. Ano pa? Ano pa yung hindi natin nasagot?
Its discovery is the purpose of conducting preliminary investigation by the public prosecutor before he could file the case to the court.
Probable cause ba, sir?
Probable cause, sir.
Oh, in relation to probable cause, ladies and gentlemen, ha, dalawang beses in-establish yung probable cause. First is probable cause to be determined by the prosecutor. We call it preliminary investigation, di ba? And if the prosecutor was able to found a probable cause, he will file the case to the court. So yan, preliminary investigation conducted by the prosecutor. Probable cause ang hinahanap niyan. Now, after it was filed by the prosecutor to the court, the judge of that court will examine that case folder to determine another probable cause. However, the name of that process is called preliminary examination. di ba? Preliminary examination if conducted by the judge, preliminary investigation if conducted by the prosecutor. They are both searching for probable cause. Probable cause. Next question. Wala na ba?
Sir, wala na po, sir.
Ah, okay. So, who got perfect? Ha? Meron? Meron siguro. Alangan naman. Napaka-basic ng mga natanong eh. Naman naman magkakamali pa kayo. So, with that, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your active participation. We have overtime. Ilang minutes to? 20 minutes. And hope you could finish your assignment. Submit, class officer, ay, class representative, mayroon ba kayo? Anyways, any person na lang who can create a Google Drive for all of your activities, kindly do it. I will be checking it by next Saturday. Ah. So, from your quiz 1 to quiz 4, I will disregard your first quizzes. So, make sure to at least perfect your quizzes. Hindi not perfect, but to increase at least to correct your mistakes before. So, yun yung isa-check ko ngayon, yung isa-submit nyo sa Sabado. Okay? Are we clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you,
yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
All, ladies and gentlemen, we are dismissed. Thank you very much.
Thank bye, you, sir. Bye, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Sir, pwede pa-upload yung record, yung meeting natin ngayon sa Canvas, sir?
Of course, of course. I'll do that. I'll send you the link.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Your excuse.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.